There are so few causes that seem to transcend political paradigms anymore. However, there is one that as we scan the independent media, freelance, journalist landscape that seems to bring credible people of all political persuasions into nearly 100% agreement. That subject is the unjust detention and political persecution of WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange. Today we come with a rare request for singleness of purpose on obtaining the freedom of Julian Assange and for him to be reunited with his wife, children, mother, father, and family. On August 31st, in the year of our Lord, 2022, we're calling on people across the world to come together for one moment in time on one thing everyone seems to agree upon and change the course of history. We chose that day because this year will be the 25th anniversary. Princess Diana of Wales lost her life, and those who knew her say she had a beautiful heart and a merciful heart. So we have intentionally anchored that date of her passing to the day we'll call upon those in positions of influence and authority in the United States, Australia, and the United Kingdom to show mercy to Julian. We begin in the United Kingdom. We are calling for what's known as a royal prerogative of mercy for Julian Assange. A royal pardon, such as was received by World War II codebreaker Alan Turing a decade ago, but unfortunately many years after his death. And by setting the Diana date of August 31st, we are calling on younger members of the royal family and MPs to lead the way on this very noble cause. A chance to do something actually beneficial that will be memorialized for future generations. On August 31st, we're calling for what will be known as the Assange-a-thon. If you are an alternative media personality, public figure, artist, or any other walk of life, plan ahead and make those days from midnight to midnight focused on Julian. Run documentaries, conduct interviews, share Julian's story. We're also requesting that individuals from different political persuasions invite each other on their shows, not to argue about the hot topic of the day, but to unite for the freedom of Julian Assange. Make it so that anywhere people go, or whatever people are watching on that day, they'll be informed or reminded of his plight. We're giving everyone a few weeks to prepare. This is not just for those in media, this is for the people of the world. If you're a baker, feature cakes with Assange's photo. If you're an artist, use your talents to join in from now until then. If you're a musician, make a song. If you're a citizen of a country, just go out and wear pins or shirts or hats, start conversations. If you're on social media, change your avatar, put your banner up, and send copy Julian and his family and send messages of encouragement. Film yourself writing a letter to Julian while he's being held captive. Read the letter and upload it to TikTok as you send it. Imagine how inspirational that'd be for others and for him to eventually hear and see. This two-part presentation is hastened a little bit because we fear for Julian's safety heading into the coming season. There are many extraordinary, both good and bad, events that are undoubtedly about to take place in the fall and beyond. As you look around, you can see that things haven't exactly been as stable as you may have remembered in the past. We must continue to right historical wrongs like this now, not later. During heavy news cycles, people often forget about unresolved ongoing persecution situations like Julian's, which can provide cover for score settling by the bad actors. Do you understand what we're telling you? We're tired of losing good men and women who simply want to bring consequential information and truths to the people. How many can you name that suddenly died over the past year, the past 2 years, the past 3 years? We're tired of losing people, and we're tired of people dying. We're tired of the persecution, and it has to stop. No more wet works. Over the past 15 years or so, independent media has been built up to a point that has never been seen before in history. But every now and then, we need a test to actually see what we are capable of if we come together as one. One people. We don't know what the outcome of this is going to be. We just felt it was our duty, and the results are in God's hands. And to Julian, when you hear this, know that you are the rarest of rare souls that has that unique ability to knock down barriers between warring tribes. You listen to everyone. You show no contempt towards those you disagree with, and we could all learn a lot from you on that. You care about getting things right. You care about protecting innocent people. We need more Julian Assanges in this world.
My name is Julian Assange. We need your help. We need thousands of people, men and women, young and old, making a difference. Together, we can bring transparency, accountability, and justice.